Welcome to the State Library at the North Carolina Department of Cultural Resources instructional series we're calling Information University, or InformU for short. Our work is supported by a Library Services and Technology Act-funded North Carolina statewide leadership grant. Have you ever lost a file due to accidental deletion, a computer virus, or other technical problem? The panic and frustration you feel when you lose family photos or an important file for work can most likely be prevented if you make a habit of storing multiple copies of your files in multiple places. Lots of copies keep stuff safe. Having copies of your files in more than one place can save the day if your computer, phone, or tablet is compromised. However, just because you backed up some of your files once a few months ago does not mean you're safe if your computer crashes. You create new files all the time, so your storage solutions are only as up-to-date as your last backup. You should periodically check your backups in case a device fails or a file becomes corrupted. If you work with confidential or sensitive information, be sure to follow your agency's established protocols for working with and saving these files. Storage media are devices where you can save your data other than on your computer, tablet, or phone. They can be used to save backup copies of files, to move files to another computer, or to share files with another person. Some examples include external hard drives, USB flash drives, CDs and DVDs, network drives, magnetic tape, floppy disks, memory cards, or cloud storage. While these options make it easy to save and back up data, be careful if you depend on flash drives, CDs or DVDs, or memory cards. They are very portable and easy to use, but are also easily damaged or lost because of their small size. In many offices, network storage is used by employees to store and share files. This storage space is often organized into shared folders on a server. Based on permissions, you can access other people's files saved in a network drive, making sharing and updating documents easy. The network drives are usually backed up by IT staff, but how frequently files are backed up varies among offices. Don't assume everything on a network drive is there forever. Check with your IT staff about retention policies. Magnetic tapes are used when large amounts of data need to be stored, but accessing the files quickly isn't necessarily required. Accessing individual files is slow unless paired with a tape library. This option is most often used for backups in large businesses, data centers, and government agencies. USB flash drives, also known as memory sticks or thumb drives, plug directly into your computer's USB port and appear as a drive where you can store files. Flash drives are commonly used because of their small size, large capacity, and ease of use. External hard drives are commonly used to store large amounts of data and connect to your computer with a cable. There are two types, hard disk drives and solid state drives. Hard disk drives are like the hard drive that's in your computer and contain a spinning disk. Solid state drives are newer, have no moving parts, and are more resistant to shock and damage. However, they are more expensive. These drives are used to back up files or transfer them to another computer. CDs and DVDs store data in the form of tiny dots that are read with a laser beam. There are multiple kinds of CDs and DVDs, including those that can have data burnt onto them, those that cannot, and high-capacity discs like Blu-rays or high-definition DVDs. CDs and DVDs are not used as much as they were for file storage. While they are great for quickly accessing files, their life expectancies are not very long, and they are of varying levels of quality, making the data stored on them vulnerable. Many digital devices, such as cameras, cell phones, and MP3 players, require memory cards. Cameras often use SD cards to store photos, and cell phones use SIM cards that save the phone's number, contacts, text messages, and other information. Newer cell phones can have micro SD cards to save music, videos, and photos. Floppy disks are now obsolete, but still familiar. They came in 8-inch, 5.25-inch, and 3.5-inch sizes. PCs used to come with a floppy disk drive, but now it would be difficult to find one. Floppy disks are a good example of an early removable storage media. They were cheap, portable, but also had low capacity and were slow. If you still have data saved on floppy disks, you should look into migrating that data onto a newer storage medium. Cloud storage is a newer option and can be viewed as both secondary and offline storage. Your files are saved onto someone else's servers, which you access through an internet browser. People can use cloud storage as another drive on their computer or as remote backup storage for their computer. Cloud backups are great for data you have saved on a device already, just in case your device malfunctions. For example, if you type your password incorrectly too many times on an iPad, you can be locked out and may have to delete all of your data to unlock your device. While deleting the data in the event your device is stolen is a good thing, it is hard to swallow when your password was entered by accident. Having your data backed up in a remote location can make this easier. Saving multiple copies of your files in multiple places is important in case one of your devices or files becomes corrupted or compromised. There are many options, so choose which is right for you and feel more secure about your files. We hope you have enjoyed this video about storage media.